What's going on YouTube? Welcome back to another Exotic Car Hacks video. And today we are not going to be talking about any of these things. These are boring. What we're gonna be talking about is animation. That's right, I'm not crazy. I haven't lost my shit. And no, I'm not trying to, well, maybe a little bit, go after those 18-year-old girls. You know what's up? No, I'm just joking. Well, maybe I'm not. Anyways, today we're going to be talking about animation because I just finished the greatest anime mural of all time. This incredible mural is basically a compilation of some of my favorite anime and video game characters of all time. And today for YouTube, I'm going to give you a very quick preview of it. Ready? Let's get into it. So it's pretty incredible that 3 weeks later, here we are. Marlon was an incredible artist, which we're gonna hear from just in a few minutes about his thoughts about this, the best work he's ever done. But this particular mural was really relevant to me because I wanted to do something different here. I wanted to give it more of a real, like, toy room kind of feel. And so I decided one day, I literally woke up and I was like, you know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna just draw all types of cartoon characters on this wall and make it really epic. So we're gonna start here with this first guy. For those of you that don't know anime, this is Evangelion Unit 1 from the famous anime Neon Genesis Evangelion, probably the best anime of all time. That was a very big part of my upbringing, which was really cool. We have a bunch of Studio Ghibli characters on top. This character most people won't recognize. This is Princess Sarah from a French anime I used to watch back when I was a kid. It's like basically a Cinderella story with some, you know, like brunette hooker. But so the other thing, these are my two favorite characters from Evangelion again. So this Evangelion had such a big thing for me, so it kind of carried on. We all know Street Fighter, Ryu right here, followed over by Macross Plus. Now this guy is not authentic because he was painted in different colors just to offset the mural, but this is the Macross robot, not Gundam, for those of you that may not be familiar with Macross. Of course, we have to have big titty anime here. That's like a must if we're gonna have a mural. You can't have a cool mural without big tits. Misato from Evangelion, and of course, the Exotic Car Hacks. I don't know what the fuck that is. Anyways, then followed by Death Note. Now, those of you that follow Death Note, this is Ryuk, Tortora the Cat, Lady in the Blue Water. We wanted diversity, you know? Like, it was all about, like, having a diverse... Why are you laughing, Reggie? Why, like, wait, I said diversity. What is it, like, Black Lives Matter? Like, we had to have, like, a black chick in the middle? Like, what's wrong with you? Why are you still laughing? Anyways. So we needed diversity, so we put that little black chick in there from Lady in the Water, which was cool. On top of that, you'll notice this is still Evangelion Unit Zero, which is also cool. And then over here, I want you to follow me on this side because it's gonna be a little bit easier to see. But true there, you can see Akira, or Kaneda, or whatever the fuck his name was. Yeah, I think it was Kaneda, from the original Akira anime. And then on this side, you still have more Evangelion. You have Chun-Li and Camille, you have Ghost in the Shell, you have Gudme the Egg, and we have little baby Goku over here. And of course, over there, we have the penguin Pen Pen, again from Evangelion. But this is just, I just want to give you a glimpse of this really cool mural. This is all hand-painted, which was unbelievable. Marlon did an incredible job, and I wanted to give him a chance to talk to you guys as well. So I basically gave him a chance to come up here and say a few words about his thoughts. So joining me today is Marlon Pruz. I appreciate you being here. So
thank you.
Beautiful work, right? We're finally done. How long did it take?
It took about 2.5 weeks.
2.5 weeks from a blank wall to this, right? So pretty impressive work. I think people lose their shit every time they walk in here and they see this. But I'm just more, I wanted to do this interview because I wanted to let people know kind of the inspiration behind this wall, but also talk a little bit about the effort it took to bring it together. So tell me, what was the most challenging part of bringing a wall like this together? Because I know you told me that this was one of the bigger projects you worked on. So tell me a little bit about what was challenging about this project.
I'd say like one of the biggest challenges was like putting it all together, making sure the composition worked. Because it's almost like a huge like jigsaw puzzle. Because you can't just put one character on top of another, you know? It just become like this big muddy mess. Like just to put them all together in a way that flows, and also in a way like with the characters that resonate with you and would resonate with the mural the most.
So this was your first time working on an anime project like this, right?
Yeah. Yeah.
Did you ever interact with anime before?
Definitely, yeah. I had taken a trip to Japan like a year ago, so it's almost like that whole trip prepared me for this wall.
Oh, yeah, cool. Yeah. What was the best part of what you think came out the best on this wall specifically? What was your favorite specific segment that was like, yeah, this is the favorite part I'd like to look at over and over?
Well, definitely, I just think like this main piece, just setting the whole mural up, just breaking all this, just this interacting with like the walls, just breaking out. I think that's probably one of the best aspects of it. Just to set it off, you know, set up the whole mood and vibe of the mural.
So when you started working with colors, I noticed that you were going in and doing multiple shades and multiple versions of the same paint, like dark purple, light purple, etc.
Yeah.
To get a 3D effect. Is that common art technique used?
Yeah, definitely. And especially like in anime, because maybe like on surface value, you'll see the anime, you might see like just one color, but if you really start looking into detail, like the dimension is created with like the intricate, like subtle shadows. So those subtle shadows form together to create the illusion of depth and like liveliness of an anime.
And was there an anime that growing up resonated with you specifically? Was there something that, or was there your favorite anime that you have now?
I think like my first introduction was, I saw Spirited Away, okay. Like in the movie theater when I was
Studio
like
Ghibli,
Ghibli for sure. And then going on to like Katsushiro Otomo, who made like Akira. So definitely made sure to put that into the wall.
Yeah, I noticed that because you added a lot of your own stuff in there, which I liked a lot because it was like a collaboration in terms of some of these characters meant a lot to me growing up. And then some of them, I like how you inserted them in there. And they weren't necessarily meaningful to me, but they kind of flowed with the mural and it really brought the idea of an anime mural to life.
Yeah.
Which is why I really enjoyed working with you specifically on this project, because I felt like you understood the project as much as you understood my vision for kind of like what I was trying to create in general. And again, thanks again for making it.
Thank you.
Really cool mural, makes this room much hotter. I mean, now that you have this rolls here, this Senna and some of these cars that are colorful and stuff, you're getting a lot more of an artsy thing. And lucky for me, my man cave is also expanding and we're gonna be taking over next door. So we'll have double the man cave space, which is pretty cool. So you can expect more awesome content, but of course more cars. And then check this out on this side. We put the Lamborghini bike. Now, many of you might be confused and you might think, well, wait a minute. This Lamborghini bike, and I don't know if you guys remember, was in my office a moment ago, but I wanna show you something. This Lamborghini bike right there, it's not that it's magic, it's that I have three of those things, but two of them are literally in the same office. So it's two of the Lamborghini bikes in the same office. And for those of you that follow me on the watch trading channel, make sure you do. If you don't know, you don't know. But this is one of those watches that you pay $100K for that's worth $250,000 instantly. So if you don't know how to turn your $100K into $250, you need to watch my other YouTube channel, Watch Trading Academy. So make sure you subscribe there. Because my watch trading is equally powerful as my car tips, so make sure you go there. But hopefully you've enjoyed the mural, and I'm gonna leave now, but like, subscribe, turn on notifications, more cool shit coming, a lot of cool cars coming, and then of course more Senna videos and a close look at my rolls very, very soon. I know you've been waiting for that one. I'll catch you guys soon.